Okay, I'm making another video blog. Today's Friday, April the 14th. And, I just want to say that I'm just feeling completely moved to be making these videos because of things that are just coming out and people speaking out about things more. Things that I've been basically trying to say since the 70s and was criminalized and silenced. All this talk about, I don't know what people's views on 9/11 are, but, 9/11 is definitely an inside job. There are numerous videos on YouTube, and one in particular that I started to watch called September 11, The New Pearl Harbor. It's full documentary and it's almost 5 hours long. And I just wanted to talk about what I've been trying to talk about since the 70s, which was the family system that people pretty much had a very just minimized attitude towards. And now it really seems to be crystal clear that everything that I've been saying since the 70s on a scaled down version about the family system is basically true. And, because, we're just living in a larger version of it today. And the family system is just a smaller version, the microcosm of the larger. And I also wanted to share about an interview that I did on Wednesday for the People's Internet Radio. I interviewed a Dr. Michelle Stevens, who wrote a book called Scared Selfless about her experience being sex trafficked at the age of 8 through about 14. In the 70s and early 80s by her stepfather. There's so much evidence. I mean, the evidence and the facts were just crystal clear when I was growing up and trying to speak out about, dealing with abuse and neglect in my own home, that everyone around you just completely minimizes and, waters down and dilutes instead of giving things the weight and calling things what it is. People just continue to add more debt to the situation instead of, acknowledging head on the seriousness of what's going on. Whether it's in the family system or wherever, and then taking steps to do things about it, people, they just keep going further and further into the debt-based thinking way by denying things or minimizing things, which is, what forced me at an early age to study psych, to, basically I lived in the gym. I was so traumatized at an early age and, lived in the gym because I was surrounded by people that were, not just in the home, but even outside of the home, which I feel like was even more traumatizing, is when you have, neighbors, relatives, like no one there for you. I mean, so the facts, basically, when I was, trying to grow up, I mean, again, these are facts. These are, undisputable facts because I was the victim witness. I was there. And the truth is the truth is that there was not one person there to raise you. Not one. All there were people making excuses about why people couldn't be there to raise you. It's just people bringing kids into the world because it's against the Catholic Church to have an abortion. I mean, and it's, we talk about, there's no value for human life today. Well, I can't imagine why that is. I mean, there's no people who bring the people, people who bring you into this world have no value for your life. I mean, again, it was undisputed when I was growing up that you had no worth. I mean, that was clear when, you know, as a child, you have no worth. And so, you know, I'm just compelled now to make these videos because of, you know, all the child sex trafficking stuff that's come out. I mean, I have been trying to speak out about child abuse in the home since the 70s. And, you know, studying it, you know, reading about it, trying to get people to engage in healthier relationship skills, active listening techniques. I mean, you know, community, family, relatives, you know, just health and fit wise. These are people that you should know have your back. I mean, if we're not living in healthy and fit, then what are we doing? I mean, it makes, you know, again, like, people, all they do is have this lowering the bar mentality instead of raising the bar. At least if you're not healthy and fit, you know, and relationships and the family system are not healthy and fit, then acknowledge it and start moving in that direction. But when all people do is, you know, make excuses and, oh, you know, oh, well, your parent couldn't raise you good because nobody taught them. I mean, like, how, you know, how is that helpful? Like, all that does is just keep perpetuating the vicious cycle. And that's not even like a legitimate excuse. I mean, people do not have the right to, you know, to just, you know, treat you like shit and neglect and abuse you because it was done to them. And you know, and the neighbors are all making excuses, like, you know, for the fact that, you know, your parents can't do a decent job. And meanwhile, like, nobody's stepping up to the plate to actually, you know, do right by you. I mean, you know, this is like a conspiracy right in your damn face. You don't need to know anything about Wall Street, the Federal Reserve, or 9/11. You know, this stuff is right in your face. But it's because, right, everybody minimizes it. Everybody just, you know, dismisses it like it's no big deal. And meanwhile, decades are going by. And it's like, you know, now we're living in a mass version of the abusive family system. And people are finding out, like, what, you know, what was a symptom right there that I was living with, that, right, exactly, like, now people are finding out that their government did sell them out, that your government is trying to kill you, that your government was involved in 9/11, you know, despite what people don't want to believe. Because I have no problem believing things like 9/11 was an inside job, because I've been living in an inside job since I'm 6 years old. I mean, again, the facts are the facts. If we lived in even a remotely healthy system, if families were having issues and parents were having, you know, trouble raising their kids through, you know, domestic violence and divorce or whatever, I mean, there would be, you know, family, relatives, neighbors, you know, there to step up to the plate and step in and actually, you know, help out and be there to help the most vulnerable, instead of making excuses for the abuser and allowing the most vulnerable to take and foot the bill. I mean, that's what I lived. People allowed the most vulnerable person to inherit the bill. I mean, there it is. The evidence is clear. And I've been literally living like that for decades. You know, and now people are talking about in this documentary, you know, the new Pearl Harbor, about 9/11 and how, oh, you know, they, like, the debunkers of the 9/11 truth movement are trying to, like, make excuses why the Air Force couldn't intercept, you know, the flight. And it's the larger version of the same thing that I lived when I was growing up. It's just nothing but excuses and incompetence and, you know, everything except just looking at the math. I mean, the excuses are irrelevant. What's relevant are the facts and the evidence is that, you know, this country was attacked And the so-called government didn't protect the people. So even at the very least, if this government's responsibility was the fact that, they couldn't even intercept any of the four planes, they're still incompetent and they still need to be held accountable. I mean, even if, no matter what the excuse is, they're still held accountable. Just like when I was growing up, no matter what the excuse is, oh, your parent couldn't raise you good because nobody taught them, it's irrelevant. The only thing that's relevant is the math and the facts and that people failed you. And that's unmistakable. And then I wanted to point out that, the actual physical reality that happens when there is no one there for children. Just last night, I was reading, and someone was posting a video and referring people to an article about professors and staff arrested for trading in child rape. And so this article lists and shows the photographs of a bunch of, academia professors all engaging and dealing in, child rape, pornography. I mean, it's just, the words hardcore and violent are used. And as I was reading the article, it talked about, a lot of them are arrested, but it also talked about how they're getting a deal. Like, one guy's only getting 5 months and, some other guy's getting like just time served. And this is, I mean, so here again is the proving my point of what I knew decades ago that, the system does sell out the most vulnerable. And the problem is, as time goes on and there are less and less people there for the most vulnerable, and again, in the case, even, 5 decades ago now, in the 70s, when I was going through the neglect and the abuse that I lived, it's over time when you're just constantly pulling the rug out, from under the people that you're supposed to be reinforcing. I mean, children are supposed to be reinforced. They're supposed to be protected like a bank account, like a national forest. At least like up until a certain age, and then they can, protect themselves. But when, so-called adults are using children to serve and fill their own needs, instead of the other way around, whether it's emotional, sexual, physical, in any way. I mean, even parents, parents I'm going to talk about, not just professors or priests or, other people, politicians or people in the White House, running a child sex trafficking ring. I mean, like a lot of parents are in on stuff too, just because they themselves are just not grown up enough. I mean, it's just like a vicious cycle. It's like there's so many arrested development people, who don't fully grow themselves. Like they don't reach their full potential themselves. I mean, like this is all just like a vicious cycle. And it's like a it just keeps feeding itself. And how can people that are arrested, development, right, they clearly they're going to be robbing from the most vulnerable instead of being there and reinforcing them. And these are all clear signs of what I've come to just call like human climate change. It's like the health and mental health version of what we're doing to the earth and pollution and climate change. And the really scary part is the fact that you know, children do not have, and young people do not have the ability, you know, this is the whole point, is, you know, young people are being used like they're adults, like they have these capabilities that they don't have, and that they're able to consent, and that they're, you know, that they're able to, you know, to handle the, you know, the stresses and the robbery that's like being put on them, you know, and then the so-called adults want to deny that there's like any consequences. I mean, when I was growing up, I mean, people actually acted as if it was negotiable. I mean, saying things to a young kid like, oh, well, your parent can't raise you good because nobody taught them, you know, is spoken as if it's negotiable, as if raising a child right is somehow negotiable in the eyes of like natural law, like natural law is gonna like let you slide or something. I mean, like who says things like this? I mean, these are not grown-ups. I mean, this is what I used to hear from like neighbors and you know, like who at the time I thought was a friend. I mean, this is not something like a real grown-up says. I mean, so it's just clear that we're living in a pass the debt down to the most vulnerable system, because that was my experience my whole life. And any time that I even tried to stand up for myself and have dignity and have self-worth, because I was the only one, my body was the only one left to do it, and then I was criminalized for doing it. So this is a health destroyer. I mean, this puts you into such a psychological and a health deficiency. When you are being trained at an early age, anybody, I'm talking about anybody, you know, any parent that is not raising their child, you know, to have self-worth, to stand up for themselves, you know, to regard themselves. I mean, that's like the most basic thing to be teaching any child, and to be doing it by setting, you know, setting an example. It's the most basic thing to teach a human being is their self-worth, which I tried to study, you know, but you know, you can't really learn this stuff by reading books. I mean, you can learn about it. You can be informed in your mind about it, but it needs to happen in the body in order for you to really know it. And if you don't have anybody around to really value you, you know, you're not going to really feel it. I mean, it's got to be, you know, instilled in you, cultivated in you, like formed in you. And so, you know, this is like where things get really dangerous. And this article about professors and staff arrested for trading in child rape. So this is what I mean about natural law. Like, there's no getting over on nature. I mean, we live in this capitalist, you know, money exchange system that isn't even a real economy, while the real economy and you know, climate change and the deterioration of the environment, you know, that I believe this is exactly the human version of, you know, it's like right in your face. I mean, how do we propose to live in a healthy society when we're just completely destroying the environment? It's not possible. And that, you know, there's no mental health in this country. Mental health is not a priority in this country. I mean, that is excruciatingly clear, because the sociopaths that be, who have rigged, you know, the system, and there's too many people that don't question it, even though, you know, glaring numbers of people are being adversely affected by it. I mean, it's just crystal clear. You know, and so these predators, I mean, it's just unimaginable. Again, and they're talking about infants. infants being, you know, I mean, if this isn't freaking complete mental illness, all because of capitalism, all because we live in a fake economy and it's deteriorating, you know, the mental health. Like, I've tried for decades. That's all I read was books about relationship skills and how to cultivate relationship skills. You know, fitness, it takes fitness. You know, nature, natural law. You have to live in alignment with nature and natural law. I mean, this should not be complicated. And yet nature just gets completely dismissed every day. Every day, we're just getting further and further and further away. You know, and so I kind of, you know, equate it. You know, I used to be an EMT for the fire department in New York for, 6 to 7 years. And, you know, you learn things about like hypothermia or when someone's going into shock and they're losing blood. You know, the first sign and symptom is their altered mental status. Like they get confused, they don't know where they are and things like that. And I believe that that's become the new normal. Altered mental status is like the new normal. I mean, people having sex with children and infants, turning and using the most vulnerable instead of giving to them. I mean, you're robbing them in the worst way. And that just erodes. I mean, it just erodes the future. And a child, I mean, you know, again, like even someone who, you know, just grew up like I did, where everybody just regarded it as normal. I mean, everyone regarded it as normal. There was nothing wrong. It was just completely, completely normal. How, you know, how you were growing up. I mean, even though nobody was raising you, you were being criminalized. I mean, in the family system, they are literally making you a criminal. No one is there to raise you, but there's plenty of people there to criminalize you. So, you know, I have to like make these video blogs because I'm, you know, extremely irate at how this stuff was like unmistakable. And I'm saying it since the early 70s. And I've just been dismissed and poo-pooed for decades and decades and decades. And I, you know, it's proven that I've been right, because now everything is like, you know, on a larger scale, and still nobody talks about the abusive family system, but you know, the child sex trafficking is like as close as it's getting now. And meanwhile, there are so many books that I've still been reading for decades about the abusive family system. And you don't, you know, you never hear anything about it. There's no lawsuits about, you know, kids, you know, being able to have any legal representation in dealing with abusive parents being abused right in their own house. I mean, I don't know, like we're destroying nature like just so incredibly. I mean, this is like really, really scary. Like we're in a mental health crisis, a mental health crisis in this country. And I knew it. I studied psych. I tried to take the taboo away from mental health and get people to just kind of regard it as no different than your physical health, you know, for decades. I mean, again, like I had no idea that, you know, the conspiracy to undermine, you know, and any attempts to do that. But what could be more important than health? Certainly not money. If money is at the expense of health, choose health, because money is fake.